Okay, it's November. I'm going to talk about New York and aim a Gunther, but first, I need a good cup of coffee. It's getting cold here in Sweden in November, and we all need a good cup of coffee. Damned. It's a really good cup of coffee. Anyway, Amy Gunther been with us for about 2 years. She's a Weactivist, and right now, more important, she's a girl. We have other Weactivists who's girls. They're not that many, but they're important. Beth Riesgott and Mercedes Helwan. God, their names is hard to pronounce, but...
All right, so guess what we're doing right now in New York City? Not what you want to do, which is take a cab. We're walking. You know why? Because in New York, we walk.
Why?
Because there's no need to take cabs. It's fucking New York. Because from the... Okay. From here to where we have to go, we'll go through two different neighborhoods. We'll hear probably 6 different languages, smell 20 different smells. It's a beautiful day in New York City, and who knows what else would happen. And it'll take the same amount of time. So. I moved here into Manhattan when I was 14 or 15, but I lived in Long Island before that. Where I grew up in Long Island, there was an empty pool. And that was the first thing I ever skated, was this pool in West Hampton. And it just kind of started from there, you know? And we would like come into the city and go skateboarding in Washington Square Park and whatever. It was like the early 90s and stuff, so. But that's when I was skateboarding in Washington Square one day. And this lady came up to me, and she was looking at me, and then like looking at my boyfriend, and looking at me, and you know, I was like kind of a fighter back in the day, and I wasn't like, ah! and I was like, why? What are you looking at? Like, why are you looking at me? Like, what are you looking at? And she was like, can I see your neck? And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, what? And she looked at my neck, and then she was like, oh, you should, you know, you should be a model. And I'm all, whatever, like, totally thought she was kidding. So then my boyfriend talked to her and whatever, and he was like, no, it's legit, like, whatever. So I went in, and that was it. Like, in, like, a week, I was in Paris. Like, they flew me to Paris, like, immediately, and that was it. My shop is in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, and the main reason it's out there instead of in Manhattan is space, because I really wanted to put a mini ramp in the store. I have a Metro card for you. You wanna know a subway secret? I saw bum shit over onto the tracks, just like this, and then the train came and it dragged the poop the whole length of the station. So gnarly. If you stand right here, there's little cameras, which are actually like security cameras or something because of the whole bombing thing or whatever. But it's really good because if you stand right here, you can see what your butt looks like. Welcome to Williamsburg, Brooklyn. And a microphone, talking dirty stories on the telephone. Show my secret love tonight, and I'm gonna make you feel right. Lick my lips and I'll suck your tongue. Down we do the bum bum bum. Let your girl come to me. I don't know, just kind of growing up the way I grew up and everything, I never felt comfortable in any environment that I was in, basically. I just couldn't. It's always been really difficult for me to do things I don't want to do. Like modeling, I could give two fucks. Like I tried to fit in, and like I tried to do what I was supposed to do, and then, you know, then I get reprimanded for skateboarding. And it's like, what do you, you found me skateboarding. Like, you found me, that's how you scouted me. Now I can't do it, you know, because I get bruised up or whatever, something like that, you know?
Doesn't look so good. Sorry I'm all hungover, you guys. I usually look a little better.
Welcome to my house in Finland. This is Oksanen, and I'm a professional snowboarder. I'm damn proud to be a new Weactivist. Peace, later.